Hi there, I'm going to walk you through this custom Kontakt instrument I made and a little bit of the process that I went through to make it. This was inspired by Junkie XL's videos series about how he works in his studio, and he mentioned this set of custom instruments that he has, and the most interesting thing about them is they're arranged across the keyboard from softest to loudest. And I think that's a really interesting way to work, because in a way it lets you have a little bit more control over the sound you're getting. But I'll post a link to that video into my blog post where I talk a little bit about that and this whole process in the notes below the video. So let's just go ahead and get started. So first of all, obviously I had to record this big old chunk of audio from the drum, just sitting at the drum, hitting it once, letting the sound decay, and doing that over and over again. As you can tell from this stuff, you can barely even hear the first hit. It's a little bit louder up until the end. It looks like these are really inconsistent, but that's just the waveform drawing in Reaper. It's a little bit wonky. Anyways, by the end, it's rather loud. Just letting the sound fully decay like that. Cool. Anyways, and then you can hit D in Reaper, and you have this function where you can split a file at transients, which was very useful for this purpose. I had to adjust a little bit afterwards, as you can read in the blog post about this, or perhaps you just read. And then I went over into Kontakt and made a new instrument. You can just go File, New Instrument, and it creates a blank instrument, but I'll skip that part because it's boring. And then I just went and dragged and dropped from Finder all of those samples and arranged them. Or it automatically arranged them. I think I might have had to do a little bit of extra editing. I can't remember. You'll probably figure it out if you really want to take the time to do this. But now I have this instrument that has all these samples from the quietest. That's not even the quietest. To quite loud. It's a lot of fun. I also obviously had to adjust the added a bit of hold, decay, and release and whatnot, and adjusted the envelope, and then added a bit of reverb just to make it sound a little bit more natural. But now I have this instrument that is all mine. Nobody else has it except me. So I can use it in my projects, and I have a really unique sound that way. I mean, it's a drum, so you can't get super unique. But, you know, every little bit of uniqueness helps, I think. So, yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you got something out of this or found it somewhat interesting. See you next time. Thanks.